Dr. S. G. V. Subramaniam is currently working as professor in the Environmental Studies Department of Anna University, Chennai. He has done 8 master's degrees including MBA, 6 postgraduate diplomas, a degree in law and doctor of philosophy in the field of environmental management and environmental law. He has done his postdoctoral work in France under the Indo-French Cultural Exchange Fellowship and at Germany under the DAAD Fellowship. He has been awarded UN Fellowship and done diploma in international lawmaking and diplomacy from the University of Joensuu, Finland. He is involved in several environmental impact assessment related consultancy works. He has guided several students for their master's degree program project works. To his credit, nearly 77 papers have been published and presented in various national and international conferences. He has been nominated by His Excellency Governor of Tamil Nadu as Senate member for 2 terms to the Tamil Nadu Dr. Ambedkar Law University. He has been nominated as expert member for the State Environmental Appraisal Committee for 2 terms by the Government of India. He has served as member board of studies in the Legal Studies Department of University of Madras. Right now, he has been nominated as member board of studies in the field of environmental studies in the Thiruvalluvar University. He has written several chapters in the leading books in the field of environmental law.
Welcome to the UGC lecture series, Implications of the Climate Change for India. Now, we will see the part 2. What is the thing which you are going to see now? The contents. Implications of the climate change in India. Number 2, climate change scenario in India. Third one, what are the consequences of the global warming? Nitrogen and oxygen are not greenhouse gases. Thank God, we are lucky. Nitrogen, nearly 78% in our atmosphere. Oxygen around 21% gases, which constitute nearly 99% of the atmospheric gases, are not having the heat trapping property. Otherwise, global boiling. The carbon dioxide is the major contributor, around 0.03% normal, 0.048% increase to the total atmospheric gases. Greenhouse gases trap heat by bond stretching and angle changes. Is global warming happening? First, everybody is made to believe that global warming is real. It is the hottest global issue. Second one, lot of statistical data is given as evidence by the Intergovernmental Panel on the Climate Change. How reliable it is. We are made to take it for granted. The 11 hottest years on record have occurred since 1990. Ironically, 2010 was described as the hottest year as far as India is concerned. Himalayan range become desert soon. Himalayan glaciers are retreating at the rate of 18 meters per year at Gangotri. Then third one, North Pole may briefly have no ice during summer. Lord Shiva is the witness of the global warming. Amarnath Shivalinga has totally melted in the year 2007 before the first prayers were offered. See the ironic condition. Then let us see the implications of climate change in India or to India. Climate change scenarios. What are the effect of the climate change? What is the impact of the climate change? First one, increase in the sea level, water, it affects the agricultural crop pattern, it affects the forestry, it affects the health, it affects the industry, and socio-economic scenarios are also changing. In terms of future changes in land use, economy, population, and even in the governance also. Because whenever there is a change in the land use, economy, and population, automatically the governance also have to be changed. What are the climate change impacts in India? First one, overview. The climate change in India, key sheet 1. Then climate change scenarios 2. Socio-economic scenarios 3, sea level rise 4, then water resources key sheet number 5, what is that impact it creates on the agriculture, that is the key sheet number 6, then what is that impact it creates on the forest, it is the key sheet number 7, then what is that impact it creates on the industry, that is the key sheet here 8, and finally what impact it creates on the human health, this is the key sheet number 9. What are the major organizations which are involved in doing that research in those areas. Take for example, in the case of socio-economic scenarios, it is the TERI, that is the Tata Energy Research Institute at Delhi, is doing the work. Then sea level rise, the major work is being carried out NIO, National Institute of Oceanography at Goa. Then similarly, what is that agriculture? Agriculture key sheet number 7, it is taken care by the IARI. IARI is nothing but Indian Agriculture Research Institute, then Delhi. Then forest, it is taken care by the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Industry, Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. And finally, human health, it is taken by the NPL, Delhi. The next one, what impacts the climate change over India? Temperature is projected to increase as much as 3 to 4 degrees centigrade towards the end of 21st century. It is more pronounced over the northern parts of India than southern parts. The next one, rainfall increases is likely to be 10 to 30% over central India. Third one, increase in extreme rainfall and rainfall intensity in all the three river basins, Ganga, Godavari and Krishna. The surface water availability showed a general increase over all the three river basins. The hydrological cycle is predicted to be more intense with a higher annual average rainfall as well as increased drought. Then sea level rise is likely to be 1 mm per year. Then increase in cyclones and wind speed along the east coast in post-monsoon season is likely. When you say because of the impact of the climate change, what has happened? Even though the rainy season was nearly 2 months, that rainy days have shrunken. Whatever that rainfall which is supposed to happen in the 2 months, it is taking place within the few days. With the result, what has happened? The total rainfall has not decreased, but the quantum of the rain which is supposed to be happened in the 2 months is happening within the few days, means more of the rainwater is being wasted. There is a large amount of the runoff. Then it causes lot of artificial flooding, and because of that there are lot of secondary effects also. And why this rainy, even though the rainy season happened to be for 2 months, but the rainy days have become only the few days, with the result the consequences are more felt, and this is because of the impact of the climate change. The next one, we will see about the temperature and crop projections in India. In this one, what is the current scenario? First one, area under the agriculture is very much declining. Second one, the rate of increase in Indian food grains production is declining since last 1.5 decades. Then attributed to frequent occurrence of weather extremes like floods and droughts and heat and cold waves. This is what just a few minutes back I explained to you. Even though the rainy season happened to be for 3 months, but whatever the quantum of the rain which is supposed to be pour in the 3 months, it is being poured only within some 10 days or 15 days, more of the water is being wasted in the form of a runoff. With the result, it is creating lot of secondary effects, and I can say it may lead to the artificial drought also for that matter. Then the next one, temperature increased by 1 degree centigrade with uncertain rainfall trends across India since 100 to 150 years. Now previously, before 100 years, we can exactly predict when the rain will happen, where it will happen, like that. But now the scenario has changed. You cannot 100% predict it. Your prediction may be 60 to 70% only because of the change in the climatic pattern. Then temperature and crop projections in India. First one, projections. Temperature increase by 2100 AD will be around 3 degrees centigrade. The next one, wheat and rice production are likely to decline, and wheat and rice are supposed to be the staple food for the Indians. Then the adverse impact of the drought is more significant on food grains when compared to that of floods. Then this is the scenario, that is the crop production requirements by 2020 to meet balanced diet norms prescribed by ICMR. ICMR means Indian Council for Medical Research. Crops, I have put in the cereals, millets, pulses, legumes, food grains, roots, tubers, vegetables, fruits, milk, etc., 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 etc. Now, requirements per day in grams, this is being given in the table number 2, that is for the average. Then requirements in million tons, In the 2000, what was that? 2010, what is this? And 2020, what is this one? If anyone happened to see this one, you can be able to see how it is rising or how it is being lowered or what is the pattern, you can be able to see this one. Because of the impact of the droughts on the Indian food grains, production from 1950 to 51 to 2012 to 2013, you could be able to see that drought in the year 1987 to 88, there is a steep decline for that matter. Because how this has happened? Because of the change in the climatic pattern. Similarly, drought in the 2002 to 2003 also, you can able to see a deep dip in these years. Similarly, 2009 to 2010 also, the same dip is there at 2009 and 2010 also. What is the consequences of the global warming? Then even you see at the international scenario at the global level, the melting of the polar ice caps and glaciers. Next one, sea level rise. As I have already told you that due to the expansion of water and also due to melting of the ice, on one side there is an increase in temperature, with the result the expansion of water is taking place, though it will be a mild one. The second one, due to the melting of the polar ice, and all these two increases the level of the sea. Submergence of the, with the result, what will happen? The submergence of the low lying areas, sinking of the coastal cities and islands. Maldives may even vanish by the end of the century if this kind of a scenario which is going on continuing. Maldives cabinet meeting was briefly held under the sea last year, which was very clearly shown that there is a concern for that climate change or global warming or increase in temperature. They wanted to show it symbolically, and they conducted that cabinet meeting that held under the sea last year. Consequences of the global warming: saltwater inundation. Second one, intrusion into the freshwater aquifers, and this will lead to the water crisis also. Shift in the rainfall pattern. I have already told you, there is, even though the rainy season is for few months, but the rainy days have shrunken. Even though the quantum of the rain has not decreased, but the same quantum of the rain what is to be poured for 2 months, it is being poured in a few days, with the result more quantum of the rainwater is being wasted in the form of a runoff. Then secondly, if it is not runoff, it will be leading to lot of water stagnation, and this will lead to the several secondary environmental impacts. With the result, you have to change in the crop pattern also. Then sometimes it will lead to the crop failures, and the crop failure will in turn lead to the starvation. Then with all these things, there will be a likely to be of migration of the human being. Migration from even from the agriculture sector, these people will migrate to the industrial side also. You see, nowadays people more from the village, they are migrating to the city in search of several jobs, for that leaving their professional practice of agriculture. And sometimes even this may lead to the environmental refugees for that matter. What is that environmental refugees? If there is war between the two countries, people will become the refugees, and they can take the asylum in the another country. Then the another country has to provide asylum for that. But on the other hand, because of the change in the climatic conditions, the people could not be able to survive in their own country, and they have to take an asylum in some other neighboring countries. Means, will the country has got an obligation to take care of the refugees? This is one of the mute question which is there, and they are called as the environmental refugees. Whether there is a suitable international law available to take care of the environmental refugees in the present day scenario, this is the one of the biggest question which has put forth because of the change in the climatic conditions and because of the global warming and because of the greenhouse effect. This is the environmental refugees. Then what are the other consequences of the global warming? First one, threat with the climate refugees, I told you. Then beach erosion, loss of biodiversity, coral bleaching, socio-economic and political disturbances. If the people's lifestyle is being disturbed, means automatically they will have a lot of socio-economic implications. Socio-economic implication means That is, even a rich may become the richer and a poor may become the poorer. And when the social conditions are changed, means automatically the political conditions will be changed. When the political topography is changed, then the governance type or the governance pattern also have to be changed for that matter. With the result, it may even lead to the internal disturbance or internal war. That is what even people are predicting. The third world war will not be unlike the first world war or the second world war. It will be for the world war for water. Then the coastline change, disputes over the maritime boundaries. Already we are experiencing between the several countries. What is the exact maritime boundary between the two countries? When there is a sea level rise, automatically then the maritime boundary prediction or maritime boundary calculation also will be very difficult. So we have left that 1 degree centigrade rise is equal to the climate change of latitude by 100 kilometers. Now what are the other consequences? 2 to 5 degree rise is enough to have Europe the climate of Africa today. You see, Africa is the nearly tropical, whereas the Europe is near that Europe is in temperate. Now the temperate climate will become the tropical climate. Then Himalayan ranges may become even the desert. Drought, desertification, climate change, severe storms, floods, winters, heat waves. Then above all, there is a spread of epidemics. Impact on the agriculture and the food security. The geographical areas of India is just about 2.4% of total earth surface, where about 17% of the global population and 18% of the livestock live in India. Then rain dependent agriculture is the mainstay of life. Rice, wheat and other cereals are the staple food in India. It is essentially a tropical country. If the global average temperature increases by 1 degree centigrade, our cereal grain production will come down by 10%. For a 3 degree increase, it is not 30% loss, but may even lead to the total failure also. Crop matures yearly when the temperature rises. Then the rate of respiration increases, Q10 value increases, but not the photosynthesis. Then more water is required per unit of food grain production, but water supply is declined because of the change in the climatic pattern. About 30% of the crop lands in coastal areas may be lost on account of the tidal floods, invasion by seawater. Nearly 7% of the crop lands may be lost for non-agricultural purposes. More power and energy may be required to beat the heat, depriving agriculture of additional inputs needed to support the yield. Then we will see about the food security. All benefits of the green revolution are lost if there is a change of pattern of the climate change like this, means we cannot be able to reap the benefits of the total green revolution. We are now talking about second green revolution. Then food inflation, food shortage, food imports have become the common. Then per capita food consumption is growing on account of economic growth, but per capita production is decreasing. Agriculture has become the burden to the farmers. This is what I have already explained to you. More of the farmers are migrating, are leaving alone the job of the agriculture and migrating to the urban areas. With the result, agriculture is declining on one hand and the urban population is increasing on the other land, and the problem in the urban areas is also increasing for that. Take for example the solid waste management, urban town planning, air pollution, then water pollution. Like that, when you see, because of the migration of more population from the rural areas to the rural areas, leaving the agricultural and coming to the industrial sector of the urban areas, this is causing several secondary impact on the environment for that matter. Now, agriculture has become the major burden to the farmers. Then which country is going to feed us? If the scenario is continuing, means then most of the countries are facing this type of a situation, means then a day will come, then which country will feed the another country, because most of the countries are facing the same situation because of the increase in temperature and the climate change. Then projected food grains production from 2001 to 2020-21. You see this projected, actual, projected. Projected one I have shown it in the black one, and the actual one I am showing it in the red one. You can able to see that on one side, Indian food grains production in million tons, and the other one the year. You see, if this one means, then in the year 2009 and 2010 there is a decline and slowly it is increasing, whereas the first projected one we have put it in the form of a linear one. So there is a good amount of ups and downs are there, with the result because of the unpredicted climate for that or unpredicted weather conditions. So in this bar chart, Indian food grains production percentage increase, you can able to see the food grains production in million tons on this side, and you can able to see the rise from 1955 to 2005-2010, and it is going on decreasing for that matter, and it is from 96 to 2005-2010 around 12.5%. This bar chart shows the actual and predicted monsoon rainfall percentage over normal over India from 1988 to 2013. See, from 1988 to 2013, if you are able to see, in some of the years it is more, that actual is more, some of the years you can see the predicted one is more, or in no way it is not even coming to the near also. With the result, there is an erratic pattern is there. Then occurrence of cold wave, frost and cold spell during December, January 2003 and its effects. That is the states affected, mostly the Jammu and Kashmir part, Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, northeastern states. Then damage is more low in lying areas where cold air settled and remained for a longer time on the ground. Now, what are all the crops affected because of that? Mango, litchi, guava, papaya, then sapota, amla, and mainly in the Assam lemon, jackfruit, peach. What was the percentage of loss? The percentage of loss was even 10 to 100% depending upon the crop and variety within the crop, for example, in the case of mango. Then how to reduce this impact? This is the major question. Proper selection of the fruit species, then the breaks of the shelter belts, frequent irrigation, smoking covering the young fruit plants with thatches or plastic shelter, air mobiling, and maintenance of the maximum depth of water in the fish ponds under aeration. Fruit size and quality of the fruits were also affected in the horticultural crops. Then temperate fruits such as apple, peach, plum and cherry gave higher yield due to extended chilling, and growth was arrested in crop fish in Punjab, Haryana, Bihar, and the mortality rate that 10% in Bihar, Mirgal, Rohu, Katla suffered high mortality due to weather conditions. Now, weather forewarning. Impact of the high maximum temperature during March 2004 Rabi in Himachal Pradesh. Increase in maximum temperature March 2004 to 2.11 degree centigrade to 7.9 degrees centigrade. Apple flowering was yearly by 15 days. Increase in the maximum temperature. These were all the following effects which were felt. Then large scale flower drop due to acute moisture stress. Then heavy rainfall during second fortnight of April, accompanied by sharp fall in temperature, caused poor fruit set. Optimum temperature for fruit blossom and fruit set is 24 degrees, while the region expected above 26 degrees centigrade for 17 days. Then coming to the major crop, namely the wheat, 8 to 10 degrees centigrade above normal in Palampur and surrounding areas during 16th to 23rd of the March 2004. Crop stage was at earhead emergence to soft duff stage. Advance harvest by 15 to 20 days and yield loss was more than 20%. Then impact of the high maximum temperature during 2004 Rabi in Himachal Pradesh. Rape seeds, mustard and linseed, flower drop and pod infertility in late sown brassica species and forced maturity in the normal sown crop. Yield reduction was up to 60% and the mustard, while 50% in linseed due to flower withering and poor seed formation. Coming to the tea, about 50% reduction in tea, green tea leaves in April when compared to 2003 and 2005. The yield reduction was seen only after 1 month. Heavy losses in yield were noticed in the case of potato matures ahead, then vegetable and pea. Coming to the egg, the production was less than by 20.9% in poultry egg. It was due to low intake of feed due to high temperature. Has the climate change altered the taste of the apples? Yes. Varieties Fuji and Suguru in Japan, the taste and texture of the apples may have undergone considerable change. You can able to feel the change also. Then over the last many years, and this change is attributed to the climate change. Increase in the global temperature over the years, specifically due to the maturation period of the fruits, may lead to bad taste in apple. Then temperature increases during bud breaking and blooming times of the fruit may advance of bud breaking and full bloom of apples. Then effect of the flood on rice production in Kerala. On one side, in this graphical thing, you can able to see on the left side production in so much of 1000 tons, and on the horizontal side this year able to see that from 700 it is not in the uniform pattern, there is an increase decrease like that it is going on taking place. You can able to see, you see how the fluctuations are there. From 1952 to 53 there is an increase, but that increase is not an uniform pattern. It has shown increase along with the several fluctuation, and now it is decreasing between, that is from the year 1982-83 onwards, there is a steep decline also. Then because of the crop failure, you could be able to see what is happening in this slide. Then the next one, drought and famine, I need not explain what has happened here. You see there is a so much amount of the breaks on the land because of the drought, because there is no water supply there, and the land has become so much amount of the this, what is this, a lot of breakages you could be able to see on the surface of the land. You see this, there is a migration, there is a fish dying for that matter. Whatever that water which was available in that area has gone, with the result there is a heavy mortality of the fish in this area. Drought and famine, you see how the land looks, you see how the boy looks, he is nothing but a skeleton, there is no muscular tissue in this fellow. Then water famine, now whatever that water which was available at a few feet, now it has gone to several feet. What which was available in the dug well, now you have to put the deep well. What which was available you can able to fetch with the hand or with the rope and bucket, we have to go for the deep bore well, by using the motor we have to draw the water. You see the effect of the water famine, now you see they are the people who are carrying the water for several kilometers also. In summary, what we have seen, I would like to put forth in the form of a brief summary. First one, implications of the climate change over India. Second one, climate change scenario in India. Then what are the various consequences of the global warming? Now I am going to put forth the two questions to you. First one, what are the impacts of the climate change on crop pattern? Then second question, how the food security is being affected because of the climate change? So let us conclude our part 2 and we will see the part 3 later. Thank you.